You're watching UseWise channel. I'm Adriana Varenik, CEO of Media Group, and here with me is Martin Varenik, your CTO.
Hi.
So we are continuing our series on your email server and getting to know it. And there is one term that people will encounter when talking about email servers, and that is DNS. Can you tell us more about history of DNS and what in fact it is?
So domain name system is a mechanism that can map symbolic names to IP addresses, and basically it was developed very early at the beginning of internet development. So everything started by assigning names to IP addresses, and it was maintained in one file called host.txt. But obviously that is not a scalable solution. So in the 1980s, DNS was developed as a distributed database that can enable you to put a name and assign IP address to that name. So you can ask DNS servers, if I have a useways.com name, what is the IP address of that domain name, whether it has mail exchange records, and you can also ask for a lot of other resources.
Mm-hmm.
So today DNS is one of the most important parts of the internet, and basically it is a very valuable asset you can have on the internet. So your email relies on DNS functionality, and you also have to take care about your domain, because that is the basis for everything you'll do on the internet.
So if you're someone that is interested only in the business value of DNS, within the company, there obviously should be someone that is responsible for taking care about your domain name, which we'll talk in one of our next videos. And there obviously should be someone that is responsible to take care that your DNS, the server that will reply when somebody sends an email to your domain, is a reliable one. And
yes, so historically people used to have their own domain name servers on-premise, but today it doesn't make sense. So most of companies would go for a software as a service solution or a platform as a service solution for DNS, and most domains were sold by internet service providers. But now we see that there is a lot of companies that are buying domains not from their internet service providers, but from other companies, and they are hosting domain name services with either Google, Amazon, or Microsoft, GoDaddy, Enom, and they do not rely on their local DNS, and especially not on their on-prem DNS infrastructure.
Yeah, and the one line in your DNS zone that tells the entire world what is your DNS is the NS record.
So yes, basically you have to nominate a number of name servers that will respond for queries regarding your domain, and usually you would have at least four or even more name servers that will be available, so that in the case of a failure of one or two name servers, people can still get answers where to send mails, packets, and where to place phone calls and stuff like that, because all of those services rely on DNS.
Mm-hmm. And not to get confused by two, but in your browser, you also have the DNS settings, which usually today will be the Google's 8888.
So that's from client perspective.
Okay.
Historically, ISPs were manipulating domain name queries, and it was done without any security. So basically, when you entered a web address or when you are sending an email, you have to ask a DNS server where is www.useways.com, and your local internet provider was able to see that you are asking domain name server and what are you asking and stuff like that. But today, for example, Chrome browser and some other browsers add a layer of security, so they have encrypted DNS query, so that no one in the between your client and, for example, Google name servers cannot see what is your your query. So it is.
And I mean, DNS is really important from business perspective as well as from the technical perspective, because if there is no DNS, there will not be any emails, there will not be any web sites on your domain.
For example, those DNS queries are also used by viruses, by malicious code, and there are a number of security solutions that you can install on your client that will intercept DNS query, and they will see that suddenly there are suspicious queries regarding names of known malicious servers and stuff like that, and will prevent incidents from happening. So this DNS is also important from security perspective. It is very important for branding, for marketing, and for reliability of services you are offering to your customers and of your ability to use internet, because if your domain is down, then basically your website is down, you cannot receive your emails, and there are a number of problems arising from such a situation.
My background is in finance and in marketing, so I'm not really somebody who was in IT or in engineering from the beginning of my career. And here is our cat. We have been cat bombed here. So I think that people in the Mimi, please. So I think that people in company that are business people, that are taking care of the business, have the right to first understand that kind of technology and have the right to insist that IT is handling this type of settings in a way that makes business sense. Because basically what you could do is you could have your DNS server on any computer, basically. But it would not really make sense. So dislocating your domain name servers to AWS, Google, Microsoft really makes sense, because it gives you high reliability, it gives you scalability, it protects your business, it protects your reputation, it protects your branding, it protects everything that you hold dear in the business. And this is why we are developing this service that will be available on useways.com when you log in with your business email address, that somebody can go and say to their IT people, please take care of this. This is not good for us. This can do so much damage to us. And also, since I was in the finance, Basel and risk management, operational risk, this is where it all stems from. It is not something that business people should not be aware of. It is something that should be taken care of and not put in some category where IT people will say we have the right to make technological decisions, because all of this is becoming more than just a technological decision. It is becoming a business-driven decision that can help your company succeed or fail.
Yes. So there were a number of cases where huge services were disrupted because domain was not renewed and stuff mm-hmm. like that. For example, Zoho had an incident where they have a software as a service model, and a lot of their customers are using it for CRM, for conducting daily business with their customers, but they were offline for a day or so because they were not able to renew their domain, so people were not able to use their services, and it was really a huge mess. It is part of goodwill and taking care of your domain name assets is really what, as Adriana said, is a part of a business plan and business strategy.
Yeah. Well, that was it on DNS. So we will have more resources on that on useways.com available in the near future. Until then, take care and we will see you soon. Thank you, Mladen.
Bye.